feel like you got all you wanted in during training camp? Such a short camp this year.
No. No, we had training camp's not over for us. We got a lot more to do. Like I said before, we started camp. We focused on a select amount of coverages, items, whatever you want to call them, and that's where we've given all of our time to. So there's a lot more that we need to get in before the season starts, but we're going to use the whole preseason to get all that in.
How much of the offense did you get in, percentage-wise?
Of the half-court offense, zero. But we got in some transition offense and some secondary offense. But until we get good with that stuff, we're not going to move past that.
Is it true that Zoe also went 3-0 last night in training?
Who gives you this information?
That would be Trudell tweeting it out.
Okay. Yeah, Zoe's 6-0 so far in the two scrimmages.
Okay, it's his team: KCP, BI, Larry, and Randall.
I think that was his team, yes.
Okay. How was his chemistry with that team last night and then compared to the team before?
How was his what?
His chemistry with that team.
He's great.
Is it the same as the group before?
Absolutely. The way he plays, he is why I said he's naturally a leader, just by the way he plays. Even though he's young and not the most vocal player, the way he plays makes his teammates better. I don't even know how many shots he took in it. I don't even know if he shot a single time in the scrimmage last night. But he instantly builds chemistry with whatever team he's playing on.
You said that Zoe is going to make Brandon better. What did you see last night? You know, it's a scrimmage.
Well, they're going to make, yeah. I mean, Zoe's going to make everyone better, in my opinion. He's one of those players that does that. I wouldn't say, you know, just single it out. Brandon will also make Zoe better, you know, with his length and his ability to get out and run and be a target and be able to kind of teach him what he went through as a rookie last year. He'll make Zoe better as well. But, you know, just the ability, just the knowing of if I get myself open, there's a good chance I'm going to be able to score, I think makes all the players better. What he looks like defensively. For Brandon, how he's running those lanes. Is he putting pressure on the rim? Would be probably the two things I'll look for most when I'm breaking down tape on those guys.
Was Brandon as vocal as you were hoping to see out of
who?
Brandon Ingram.
Yeah, he's been great. We want him to talk more defensively. He's been vocal from a leader standpoint as far as, you know, calling people out and holding himself accountable the way he's playing. But I still want to hear him talk more, you know, possession by possession as far as just calling out his coverages and things like that.
There's a lot of excitement about kind of the step that everyone seems to expect Brandon to take. Why is it that you believe that this year he's going to be somewhat dramatically better than year
ahead? I believe it because of hard work. I see the way he works every single day, how committed he is to this game. I'm under the belief that he's going to be, over time, you know, one of the better perimeter players in our league. And I've told him, don't put too much pressure on yourself, because it honestly doesn't need to happen right now. Just keep working the way you work. Keep getting better on the things you need improvement on. In your natural game, the way you see it, the way you play it, you'll become one of the best players in this league. So I want him to make sure that he's still out here having fun and enjoying playing basketball, and instead of just worrying about the pressure or stress of making a huge jump as soon as the season starts.